Instagram, pure temptation. Sex with me, sex with me, sex with me. Hello everyone, how are you today? Personally, I'm pretty good. I mean, like, summer is coming very soon. It's hot, as you can see. So definitely, that's all I need to be happy. And I know it's been a while, okay, but now I'm back. I have like a few topics in mind, okay. So you know who is coming. You know, like, you know, I'm gonna talk.
We just talk. Can we just talk? Figure out where we're growing.
And talk a lot. So, like usual, it's gonna be some controversial topic, some random topic, you know, the one that, like, you maybe want to talk about, but, you know, those people out there are just looking at you like, oh my god, we don't have time for that. But no worry, because boy, girls, I'm here. I got you. So let's get started. So, today's topic is gonna be virginity. I know, I heard so many videos on YouTube about this. I'm not going to talk about like the actual like losing virginity thing, you know, that's not what. I want to give you a different point of view on this. I want to talk about all the pressure that you have and how you can kind of overcome them when you're still a virgin, or, you know, when maybe, I don't know, when you haven't get a boyfriend yet, or this kind of stuff, or girlfriend, you know. It's going to be for guys and girls, you know, I'm talking like very general point of view, because I, you know, summer is coming, and, you know, I heard people talking about gonna get a guy, and people are like, oh, I hope it's gonna happen, and this kind of stuff, and
make love to me.
I was wondering, like, why are you so worried about this? It shouldn't be. It shouldn't be something worrisome. Or maybe it's just because I'm very, like, straightforward, very strong in my mind. You know, I have my opinions and my convictions. And sometimes people are really just too influential. You know, I mean, like, it shouldn't be. When it's something so intimate and personal, why? Why would you let other people, you know, like, decide, tell you how you have to do something like that? This is your thing. Honestly, having a relation, a sex relationship with someone, is not, it doesn't involve other people, unless you're doing like a orgy thing, but that's not like the first time. And it would be weird, honestly, it would be very weird if your first time you did it like with many people. I mean, everybody's different, not judging, I mean, low-key judging, but, you know. I mean, you do whatever you want, okay? But what I'm saying, like, I'm talking about, like, the one-to-one thing, you know?
You my only one. You my number one. You're one-on-one. I wanna go one-on-one with you.
It's your own moment. So you have to decide how you wanna share it, how you wanna spend it. What kind of memory do you want? My rules, me, in life in general, not just about that, you know, like, in life since I'm young, you know, until now, and I think for the rest of my life, it's always to try not to have regrets.
Don't wanna wake up one day wishing every time more. I wanna live fast and never look back. That's what we're here for. Don't wanna wake up one day wondering where it all go.
It's hard to do because sometimes it's gonna happen because you can control everything, you know, life is life. But when you can, when you have that possibility to do it, like with your virginity, then just do it. Decide how you want to do, what kind of person you want for that first time, okay? So don't let the society tell you that it has to be the love of your life.
Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges. Are your perfect imperfections?
No. If you feel like you want to do it just for yourself, with a good person, with a friend, with a stranger, a foreigner, whatever, that's your choice. That's what you have to think about. You have to think about yourself, you know. You have to think about what will give you the best memories. Do you want it to be like a relationship thing? And maybe the danger with that is going to be linked to the relationship. So when you're gonna break up, if it's a bad breakup, you cannot destroy the whole thing. or you want it to be with a friend, then in that case, I mean, like, you only want the experience, the connection. You don't really want, like, all the other stuff, the dating thing, the, I mean, love. No, no, you know, some people are like that, you know, like, they don't want, like, a love, love, love. You have your whole life to find love, but I mean, this kind of experience, you know, especially for men, I'm so sorry, but I know that for men you are really pressured to do it very early. If you feel you're ready, I heard it so many times, like, ready, what is ready, what is ready, what is ready? I used to thought like that, you know. I used to, like, watch those videos and be like, what is ready? Ready is when you feel like you want that person to touch you, want to go that far with that person. You're not scared. When you lose that scare, that fear, that's when you know you're ready. If you heard the bad story, the good stories, you took all of these and in your mind you make like a range. You be like, oh, it could be like that, like amazing, or it could be really bad, like this. It could be, like, you know, painful, it could be weird, it could be awkward, like the worst thing ever. Prepare yourself mentally for each possibility. After, you have to find a person that will make you feel like, with this guy, with this girl, that's gonna be how it wants. It's not going to be the magical moment that you expect, but at least the experience itself, that's going to be amazing. But the moment you're going to share with that person, that's what you don't want to regret. You don't want to feel used. When we talk about, like, how people are pressured about virginity, I want to talk to everyone, you know, that knows a virgin friend. Don't exclude that person from knowing, from understanding, from learning from you. I hate those moments, you know, when you talk to people and because you're different, it can be because of your race, your age, your background, whatever, they're not talking to you the same way. They're talking to each other like, oh, you know, you know, you know.
Big dog, my man.
Yeah. And when they're talking to you, like, do you understand? You want to explain? I mean, you don't know because, I mean, you know, you're not from there, you're not doing this, you're not in a club, you haven't done this. Maybe they really want to learn, but you make them feel like they're not part of the group because they're not like you, they haven't done the same thing as you. And that's really bad because that person's going to feel lonely. That's gonna be a first, like, you know, break in your trust in the relationship. They don't know me. If they knew me, they knew that they could talk about anything, that I will try to understand. If I have questions, I will ask them because we are friends or we are like families, we are close. But they don't have to make you feel like you're different, like you're less than them because you haven't done the same thing. Please, people who are doing this, can you just stop? Can you just, like, you know, right now, think about those people that are, like, different for some reason around you and just, like, be like, okay, guys, we should stop, like, treating her like she's a child or like she's, like, an ovni, an alien or coming from some other world. No, that's going to make her or him feel comfortable to ask questions because that's what you want from your friend. If you cannot even get answers from your friends, you know, from your friends or your family, that's how you end up on internet and having, like, so many different answers. You're just gonna end up confused and even more pressured, okay? Other pressures, like, can come from age, from race or culture, like, you know, from patterns, like, you know, in your village, in your culture, that's the age you should do that. No, 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 no. We are human beings, we are individuals. You didn't decide where you were born. You didn't decide in which culture you are in, but you can decide whatever you do, okay? With your body especially, you know?
My body, my mind, my choice.
Give yourself some time. Don't be afraid. It's hard. It's hard to tell people, like, no, I don't understand. I know it's hard, but that's the confidence you have. If you don't even have confidence to admit it, how can you have confidence to do it? The experience is going to be so much better if you accept all the fears and all the questions, adapt, and just go with the flow, okay? Maybe we're perfect strangers. Maybe it's not forever. Maybe the land will change us. Maybe we'll stay together. Maybe we'll run away. Maybe we'll realize. you don't have to control everything, don't worry, but just, you know, you have to prepare your mind. The preparation is not only on your body, it's also your mind. First, you have to listen to when your body is ready, but also to when you feel like that's the right time, and don't rush stuff. It's a very complicated topic to talk about virginity, because I understand that it's not easy, especially for me. If I have one advice to give you, you have to be honest with yourself. If you feel comfortable with someone, you have to let them know that you're virgin as soon as possible. And you don't have to apologize for this. There's nothing wrong about that, okay? It just means that you have value, that you value it. And you value it to a point when you rather like wait and have a wonderful time than just do it because, that's what people do, okay? If you want to do it early, if you want to do it with someone you don't know, it doesn't matter. That's your choice. But you have to be able to say that I did that because of that. I'm really a justifying person. If you're going to justify yourself with your own words and be honest to yourself and be like, no, I didn't do it because everybody was doing it. I did it because I felt like this was the right time. That's the story I would not be ashamed to tell people, even if it was good or bad, because I can assume and take, like, you know, responsibility for my actions. Then that's the right mindset. So if that person is giving you what you're looking for, then that's the right person and the right time to do it. If you're looking for trust in a friend, just do it. If you're looking for adventure, if you're just looking for someone's gonna respect you or respect privacy, then if you find that, just go for it. Doesn't matter if it's the love of your life, if you're in a relationship or not, okay? If you wake up one day and you'll be like, okay, the next person's going to come, I'm going to do it with him, that's your choice, but there must be a reason behind it. And that reason just doesn't have to be because I'm at the age I have to do it, because people said you should do it, because people are like, what the hell, you haven't done it yet? Oh my God, why? Oh my God, are you okay? Maybe you're too this, you're too that, you're too that. Yeah, but I'm all of this for reasons. I mean, like, I'm sure a lot of people are waiting to do the first time, or who are kind of feeling that, you know, it's taking a while, or that maybe a bit too demanding. I'm sure these people have many opportunities, occasions to do it. But at one point, you look at yourself and you're like, is it really what I want? If that person really worthy of this, you said, I just woke up and did it, and you cannot back it up with your confidence, your beliefs, and your convictions, then it's over. Then you're just like one of those following sheep, what just like, you know, victim of pressure. So they were judging you because you didn't do it, and when you did it because they were telling you to do it, then they judge you because you were just following the crowd. You see how vicious this circle is. That's why you have to get out of this, take your time, and decide whatever you want. Stay with it, stick with it, until, you know, with time, with friendship, maybe like the week after you take the decision is going to happen, the year after, nobody cares. As long as you feel that that's the right thing to do, when you do the pros and cons is better for yourself, you, that's the words, yourself, then everything is fine. Doesn't matter who, doesn't matter when, doesn't matter where. Then you can do whatever you need. That's all you need to know about virginity, is that you have to say it. You have to be able to feel comfortable with it, because there's nothing wrong. There's nothing absolutely wrong. It's a choice, it's your value. And if people are talking like, oh yeah, you say that because, that's when you come with the confident girl. Friendship
never ends. It's sassy, isn't it? It's sassy. You have got to give. Taking is too easy,
but that's the way it is. So it's just always on A to Z. But you know, that's the kind of confidence you need. If you can reach that, then you will be comfortable with anything, with doing whatever you want in your life. You know, so many people are just judging you by the picture you're posting, by whatever you're saying, by the attitude or your reactions, just because they can't do it, or, you know, something's stopping them. People around are stopping them, but you are not. If you can't do it, I'm still gonna do it, because, I mean, I don't give a fuck. It's my life. If you don't like it, just go away. If you don't like it, just go away, okay? So that's the point I wanted to make. I don't know if I was very clear. If you need more explanations or you think I'm going off topic or I said something wrong, just let me know, or in the comments box below, or you know, you have always my three favorite: Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. You can always, you know, hit on me there. I will answer. Please no dogs, okay? I'm not really into that. But apart from that, I think we are good for today. I wish you a wonderful week and a very good summer. Goodbye.
Sex with me is amazing, but her it'll feel alright. Sex doesn't get any better, make it long, let it be all night. I know, I make it hard to let go. Tonight on that.